Live at you in a few minutes. This is Daily Hit.
Amrek, what's good, bro?
What's going on, homie, huh? Jordan Tower, what's up?
Your shit's frozen, B.
It's frozen?
Nah, hold on. Yeah. I got you, hold on. What's good, everybody? Hold on, let me get Rec right. I'm gonna have to reconnect his window. Alright, there you go. You back. Rec, what's good, man? Daily Hip Hop News. Jordan Tower, Amrek.
What's up, Jordan? What's happening, family?
I'm chilling, man. Just enjoying the news today, bro.
Yes, sir.
We got a lot of people in the room. We got 21 people in here. Shout out to Ricky. Shout out to Mark Doe, Prada 90s, Moses 187. Guys, make sure you check the Patreon below. We need your support. Check the Patreon below to help this broadcast better. I just spoke to Mr. Fab. He's going to be on the broadcast probably sometime this week. Spoke to Zoe Dollars. We're going to have Zoe Dollars come on the broadcast. Mm-hmm. MREX working on Turk from the Hot Boys. And Petey Crack soon to come. We're going to get a lot of people on here, man. I got OJ the Juice Man coming. Yeah, we're getting people on here. We were just testing it out with Cicero yesterday. It was pretty good, but we're going to do the Skype thing next time so you can hear him better. Anyways, guys, we're going to get into the news today. We got 100 people watching right now. The news is Beanie Siegel just exposed Meek Mill today. I mean, Rec, whoa.
Woo.
This was like the third game diss, and it didn't, like, games didn't even have to drop a diss. There's so much to talk about today, guys, that we're going to definitely be in here for a while. And I'm going to take comments from the chat room. Make sure you guys get involved in this because this is a crazy thing. Woo. So Meek Mill, Tackstone, interview with Beanie Siegel. Beanie Siegel basically exposed everything about Meek Mill. I mean, like, he did the job for Game. He did Game's job for him. Isn't that crazy, Rec? He finished Meek off. Game didn't have to spit one more bar. He dropped that video. Beanie Siegel finished him off for him. I mean, guys, do you think Meek Mill can come back from this? Can Meek Mill come back? Now, we're going to go over everything and then stay in the chat room. And I'll get, like, info from the chat room in a second. We'll have a discussion about this. Is Meek Mill finished? Do you believe Beanie Siegel? Okay, so one point Beanie Siegel brought up is that he's like, I didn't just write O'Malley's verse, right? Oh, I didn't write this. I wrote a majority of the diss track to Game. Do you believe this? Do you believe that he wrote a majority of the diss track towards Game? He wrote Meek, and he's saying not only did he write O'Malley's verse, he wrote Meek's verse. What do you think about this, Rec?
I think it's shocking.
It's shocking. I mean, Meek Mill needs help. Does Meek Mill need help?
I mean, outside of the whole writing aspect of Beanie Siegel, you know, writing for O'Malley and Meek.
Yeah.
Just everything that played out in his conversation on you know, tax season. We got to report the news right. We ain't no haters. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
That was the platform Beanie Siegel was on.
Mm-hmm.
And he brought up some powerful stuff. I'm talking like, you was never that dude. You never had a fight.
Oof.
You was known as a dirty kid on a motorbike.
He was basically coming for a street cred.
I mean, because Beanie Siegel street cred got attacked.
Yeah.
With the punch, and they put it on camera. And he like released the whole footage.
This is true.
He was cool with it. He like, it's cool. You caught that sucker punch.
Yeah.
But released the whole footage. And he said, "Reach." And he said, "Real G's don't respect that." You know what I'm saying?
Now I'm gonna tell you guys. If you guys have questions or you have statements that you want us to address in this, at Jordan Tower JTF on Twitter, just tweet me a question and also put the link to the live, you know, to our live thing and say, hey, Jordan, da, 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 and I'm going to read them off in about 30 minutes. We're going to go back to back. And I'm also going to read in the chat room. All right. So he basically said, Meek Mill, you ain't street, buddy. A street dude wouldn't act like this, right? Wreck.
Yeah, man.
A street dude wouldn't act like this, right?
You talking about Meek?
Yeah, he's talking to Beanie Siegel to Meek on the Tax Stone.
Uh-huh.
What did he say? He said basically Meek's not street, right?
Basically just said he's a dirty kid on a motorbike.
He's a dirty kid on a motorbike, so he's basically saying he never sold drugs, right? He was basically just a rapper. He's not a street dude. He said, you never had to be in a car crying with your homies, not wondering if you guys are going to make it back or not. Right? Remember that?
At all. Like,
woo!
It's crazy.
It kind of discredits Meek's whole thing. Right?
Yeah. If you base Meek Mill as a street rapper, and
which his whole thing is about being street. He's always quoting street stuff. He's always taking pictures. Now it makes, I mean, you know, not to discredit Meek, because Meek still has to come back. So let's try to be unbiased here.
Yeah,
Meek.
Nah, let's do this. Okay. There's always three sides to a story.
Right.
We heard Game side. We heard Siegel's side. Let's hear Meek's side. It's only right.
But do you think we're going to hear Meek's side? I don't want to hear it through Instagram, do you?
Meek got to speak. Those are powerful.
He got to go do an interview somewhere. Hot 97, yeah. Something.
No, I like Siegel. He went, you know, it's cool. He went to Tax Stone Salute. Siegel got to, Meek got to come to a platform like us. He got to come to Daily Live Hip Hop. Daily Hip Hop.
And be
Live.
Raw with it, right?
And be raw with it.
Do you think he should?
Raw platform.
Now, if you were to go to a podcast, what podcast should you go to? Drink Champs?
He can go to Drink Champs, you know, Salute the Norby and all that, you know.
Or do you think he would go to Rap Radar?
He probably would try to go, let me see.
Because he can be more raw on a podcast than he can on, like, a Hot 97, right?
Yeah. He'd probably try to go Rap Radar. Who else is out there? Oh, Combat Jack. I don't know, but yeah, he'd probably go Rap Radar.
One of those three he would go to. Now, basically, he also said, Drake, you had beef with Drake, right? And I told homie, in this beef, he was basically giving him advice for the Game beef. He said, basically, you have more power in silence. You have more power in silence. Because
silence is golden. I tell people, you don't have to respond. Like, yesterday,
right?
Dude was trolling in our chat room.
Right. Yeah.
And there's people saying, y'all gonna let him troll like this?
Mm-hmm.
Silence is golden.
You it's understand true.
What I'm saying? So that's what Siegel was saying on the podcast.
Yeah.
It would have been better for me not to respond to Drake.
Yeah.
You
know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm with you.
That's a gem.
Yeah.
That's a fact.
You're right.
So, you know. I mean, it's crazy, man. We can go on and on. I mean,
go on and on. That's a Drake song.
Crazy. Basically, also, where does the Drake beef come from?
Right. He said that it comes from. Oh, hold on. It comes from Drake probably slept with Nicki.
Drake probably laid the pipe to Nicki Minaj.
And this is basically what he said. He said basically, you were laying in the bed with Nicki one night, and you asked her that question. And we've all done this, okay? Every guy has done this at one point in your life when you're young and stupid. You ask the girl, did he suck his dick? Or, you know, did he do this? You know? He probably asked a question like that. Did you sleep with Drake?
Yo.
What?
Basically, he asked Nicki, did Drake bust your drawers?
Yeah.
We gotta have our own slang and everything on here.
Word.
Meek was like, Nick, did Drake bust them drawers?
Right.
And she didn't give Meek the answer he was looking for.
She ain't give that, like, nah.
That confident answer. No. She ain't give that confident no. You understand?
Right.
She gave him that silence, that long silence. It was crickets.
Right.
It was spooky in the room. It got spooky in the room.
It was spooky.
You know what I'm saying?
It was spooky. Cause
hold on. I'm trying to get on to see the what people type in and people in the room, but every time I try to get on, it's lagging. You understand what I'm saying?
What you mean?
Like when I go online.
Okay.
To go on to the YouTube feed.
Okay.
The FaceTime lags.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's all I'm saying. Like for me, on my end.
Let's put it this way. Does MREC have to upgrade his server?
Oh, hold on. You throwing shots? That's what we have.
I just sent you the link, buddy. So anyways, do you guys think that Meek Mill, I mean, do you think that Drake and Nicki actually slept together? I think he busted down. I think he busted down. What do you think? I think he did it. I think he busted down. And so, basically, we got...
But hold on.
What?
Deagle also said it was some information in terms of that topic that he can't say on a podcast because he's not like that. It's like Meek.
Oh, about the street aspect, right?
No. Meek pretty much told him something would happen with Nicki and I guess Drake. But remember he said that in the beginning? But I'm not going to speak on that.
Oh, yeah, because he said that Meek Mill told him something about his lady and he should have kept that to himself because what happens in your house should stay in your house. And that's a good point. Sometimes people divulge too much information about their personal life. You know? You got to just keep that stuff separate. Right? Because then, who knows? You might have a problem with Beanie Siegel later. Now he's got this ammunition. And look, who got a problem with Beanie Siegel today? And he got that ammo. You're lucky, Meek. You're lucky that Beanie Siegel has some integrity and morals. That he won't spill all the beans. He said Meek Mill does a lot of lame stuff in Philly. I ain't going to get into it. I mean, this is just open season. When Beanie Siegel comes out and says this, the guy who reps Philly and protects the honor of Philly, he's letting you know, open season on Meek Mill. You got A-Rab, all these guys in Philly that might just spill the beans. Now, they were doing it out of respect for their city before, just keeping things private about Meek Mill. Because you know what? If the city looks weak, it looks weak upon them. Because Meek Mill is the winner in the city right now.
Thanks.
And they were trying to protect their city. But look now, we got a problem. Because you got Beanie Siegel coming out, giving the okay. I mean, I'll be honest with you. When I did that video with Meek Mill before he was signed... What? What happened? When I was, when I did the video with Meek Mill, like way, way, way back before he was signed to Ross, okay? I had like Freeway hitting me, everybody hit me, thanking me, like, yo, thanks, because he was the new guy out and they needed new blood. And they were happy he was coming out and that someone was giving him a shot. Then Rick Ross came and signed him, boom, he was out of here. Repping for the city properly. Meek comes with the bars and everything. I don't know why Meek needed Beans to write on that. I mean, let's be honest. The whole diss towards Game that Beans wrote, allegedly, right? It wasn't that crazy.
It was crazy, but you can tell a spitter was a part of that.
Right. Yeah, but, like, it wasn't that crazy. It was more about, like, yo, I'm going to catch you in traffic, go to Calabasas. That's a typical. Game was coming straight.
Now, Game came for blood.
He came for blood. He was naming certain things in his life. And damn, it was crazy. Like every line was, like, crazy. It was getting very personal. He was, you know, he's talking about, he was breaking down how Meek is a mouse to him, you know, calling out Safari. That's how we got Nicki, you know, FaceTiming Safari while he was fucking a porn star bitch, right? And then telling Nicki, yo, your man's cheating on you, right? This is where Drake gets checking for an earpiece, please, checking for you. That's where he gets all that from. He just wasn't going too crazy into it.
He ain't going to death.
Yeah, he probably knew all this. I mean, this is like, I've heard this rumor before. Everybody's heard this rumor before this in the industry, but you don't want to believe that. Especially if you're a fan of Meek's music.
Thanks.
You know? I don't know, man.
I mean, it's crazy, but let me know if you can hear me because it seems
I can hear you fine. I can hear you fine.
It's like every time I talk, it cuts off on my end.
Right, I can hear you fine, bro.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, whatever, fuck it, I just gotta deal with it.
You just gotta deal with it.
But this is my thing. So Meek Mill and Beanie Siegel has beef. I mean, of course, because Meek Mill so-called goon put hands on him, the dude Teefy.
Right.
So that right there, but Beanie Siegel just made it clear.
Yeah.
Meek Mill, they was on the phone, Meek Mill said, I could put a bag on your head, off. You know what I'm saying?
That was crazy to me. Like, not only, like, you know, Beans was trying to help Meek out, right? He's being the old OG, right? You go to your OG for assistance, right? He's telling him what he needs to hear because Meek got too many yes men around him. You need, and Master P said this best, get some no men around you. He said this to Chris Brown. He said, yo, man, Chris Brown, you got too many yes men around you. Get you some no men. Some people that'll tell you no and tell you what's best for you, right?
Thanks.
And that's what Beanie Siegel is to Meek, and he should cherish that, right?
Beanie Siegel is Meek Mill OG, but Meek Mill's looking at it from, I got more money than you. I'm more popular.
That's where he took it.
So he's not respecting, Siegel's saying, he's not respecting the G-code.
Right, and Beanie Siegel said, yo, money ain't never make me. Exactly. Money doesn't define anybody, and never let somebody tell you that. All those people in the chat room, everybody watching.
Let's do this. Money, or it doesn't matter how popping you think you are, how many followers you think you got.
Right.
That doesn't mean shit.
Exactly, because you could be lonely with money. Miserable with money. There's people that kill themselves with money.
Fuck, nigga.
Or whoa.
Calm down
over there.
You could be grimy with money or without, but
yeah,
money doesn't define.
Yeah, if you're a liar and a cheater, you're still going to be a liar and a cheater with money. If you're a guy with no morals and you got money, you're going to be a guy without morals but with money. Now, maybe you have more friends when you have money, but they're only with you because you have money. So what's Meek Mill without money? That's what Beanie Siegel's basically getting to.
That's what he said.
Yeah, that's what he's getting to. Where's all your friends going to be without the money?
But then he also said, you ain't got real classics. You right. don't have a feeling in the air.
Ooh, that, yeah. He said, I'm a legend now. I'm a die a legend. You're still working to be legendary.
Facts. Then he said, facts.
Oh, yeah. Everything he said. And, you know, Beanie Siegel also, obviously, this guy loves to do laundry, okay? Because
he said,
we don't come out in the wash cycle, we'll come out in the rinse cycle. He said, again, what doesn't come out in the wash cycle comes out in the rinse cycle. So he's basically saying the truth will come to the light. It always does.
I always say
and
that.
Look what's happening right now. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. I feel bad for Meek because I was rooting for him in this beef. Honestly, I was hoping.
Still root for Meek.
I don't know. Right now, once you make that call and get Beans beat up, that's like another level, bro.
Hold on.
What's up?
Let's separate the man away from the music.
Okay.
Because you got fans in the room.
That's true.
And a lot of these fans didn't live the street life.
Right.
So they want to hear the music. They want to hear Meek, you know.
Get to it.
You want to hear Meek responding to Game Pest Control. They want to hear that.
I want to hear that.
Yeah.
I want to hear that too.
No. So you can't be disappointed in Meek the artist. Be disappointed in Meek the man.
I'm disappointed in Meek overall, bro.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is...
What's up?
You got people that's never going to understand moral code.
Yeah.
I don't care how many live streams or how many podcasts Beanie do or how many live streams me and you do.
Right.
That's something that has to be instilled in you.
That's true.
From
you're right.
Parents or from upbringing.
And that's true. So what are you getting at here? Like, are you saying that Meek has no morals inside of his soul? Is he moralless? Is that what you're saying to me?
Then Beans said, Beans was talking to the dude Tiffy.
Right.
And he said, how you let a non-believer, a non-Muslim, come in between you, me, and Allah?
Woo! Ooh, that was crazy. Get into that, Rec. Break that down.
Pretty much, if me and you believe in the same principle, especially dealing with God, how do we let a person who believes in the devil come in between us?
Whoa, I don't think he meant that.
No, because a non-believer pretty much worship materialism. See,
okay.
But
do you think he was referring to being a Muslim or just God in general?
A Muslim is just a person who submits to God.
Right, but when he's saying this, right, because most of the biggest Muslim community lives in Philly. That's a fact in this country.
Yeah.
They have the biggest Muslim community, right? So he was talking to him, when they call each other brothers, they're talking about the brotherhood of Islam, right? Muslim, right?
For the most part, yeah.
So Tiffy is obviously his Muslim brother, right?
Mm-hmm. He said they prayed together. That's deep.
And what did they call that on Friday? They have a prayer on Friday. What's that called?
You go to Juma prayer.
So, yeah, but they probably do Juma every Friday together.
You make a lot doing Juma prayer.
Yeah.
On Friday.
Yeah. You know, you could tell Beanie Siegel's trying to live his right life right now.
I think it's around noon or one-ish, around that time.
Yeah.
You know, but you pray 5 times a day. Like, if you're a true Muslim.
Oh, no, yeah. I mean, we know from being in New York, you go by the meat cart, that shit shuts down a couple times a day, and they bring that carpet out, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, that's you're used to
that's
that.
That's why the Siegel thing is real deep outside of rap.
Right.
Outside of, okay, yeah, you snuffed me. Your man snuffed me. Your goon snuffed me.
Yeah.
But I get busy with the hands. Let's try that. And B said, yo, I got one lung. My health is bad. But you know what? One-on-one, I still scrap. I'm not making
I didn't get to that part. So he's willing to get down and scrap with Meek Mill.
Meek Mill, Tiffy, whoever.
Guys, don't be surprised if you hear a Beanie diss in the morning. I think he's ready right now. He woke up a sleeping giant.
This is what I need you to do, because I'm in a blind right now. What the people in the room talking about? I'm curious.
Guys, talk to me in the room. Someone said, yo, stay on topic. F Meek. Beans is king of Philly. Beans is king of Philly. We know that.
Salute. Who said that? Salute.
Anska. Anska must be a Meek Mill fan. And you know, well, I'm a Meek Mill fan too, okay? So don't get it twisted. We're just spitting facts right now. Yeah, he's putting zzz and then like you're talking about the Meek thing. But you know what? He said I'm dumb. But I'm gonna be honest with you, bro. I'm just spitting facts. Go watch that interview.
I said to you, Jordan, no matter how many live feeds or live streams we do, if you don't have morals and principles instilled in you, you're not going to understand.
Someone said, Jarvis said, Emrek talking that shit.
Salute.
Christias, Nicki Minaj's career fell off after dating this dweeb. I'm going to tell you something. Nicki Minaj hasn't dropped an album since she's been dating him. I'll tell you that much. Bar Street Bully, get Bully Karma right at Jordan. Bean sounded meek going on Taxstone. I liked it. At Jordan, Meek Mill playing chess. No, he's not. He's playing checkers. Let's be honest.
That's what Bean said. You got to listen to the interview.
Who's the bitch with Jordan? Come on. Don't disrespect them wreck like that. He's got Forbes DVD, one of the number one websites. Okay? JTF, what's up, Church the MC? LeBron, I saw him. Meek is king of Philadelphia. Yes, to the youngin' he is, but to...
Hold on. I don't think they got me. Meek Mill gets busy.
Yes.
For his lyrics, bars, he gets busy. Yes. Is he fucking with a Siegel? No.
No.
It's two different type of artists.
Okay.
You understand what I'm
saying? And Ansgar OJ will come into this chat within a week. Okay.
Who's that?
They asked for OJ. We'll get OJ in here.
Oh, yeah. OJ will be here soon.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Rakeem Bruce, what's up? Ben Allen, even though you keep dissing me, what up? Moses 187, what's up? Samuel Kane, what's up? Moses 187, Jay Ski. Show Intelligence, Low Ski 100. Make sure you guys click the Patreon link below and support this.
Support.
It's like a podcast live YouTube, and you can watch the replays after.
This is something new. Everybody's doing
something new, but it's something great. Okay, anyway. Sup, Jordan. I like the OJ Juice videos. All right. Terrence, the Don Chef. Trey Noble, Philly looking real bad lately. I'm not going to judge the whole Philly. Some people might, though. Meek got frustrated and flipped the checkerboard. Chris 714. Young Ink, like Ben King. Saru Beg, Gilly is the king of Philly. He's one.
Salute to Gilly.
Yeah, that's salute to Gilly. He's definitely a real one. OJ, no, OJ the Juice Man, the rapper. OBH run Philly. On that street side, they kind of do. They're very tied in. I really want to check, how can we rebound? Okay, this is how we can, I'm going to pause right there. How can we rebound? Okay, and peace to Semi-Kane. Okay, how can Meek Mill rebound? Meek Mill has to hit the studio, get us a diss track in the morning, and then drop DC4 the next day. No. I want a video. Bruce, I want a video.
Bruce.
What's up?
Meek Mill has to clear the air.
He should clear the air on Feel It in the Air. Beat.
Woo!
Woo!
That's kind of hot.
Yeah.
Let's put that in the universe.
That would Meek be hard. Mill. That would be a hard freestyle,
Beanie
too.
Siegel diss.
That would be hard.
No. Beanie Siegel game diss.
This is, okay, I'm going to tell you guys, this whole beef.
That right there is classic.
But this whole beef could morph right now, right? It could turn into a Beans versus Meek thing, and that could be very dangerous, especially in Philly.
In Philly.
You don't want two people beefing in Philly that are really in the streets, because other people are going to be fighting other people, not just the rappers. But we don't want people dying over some beef, some rap beef. We want bars.
Listen, let me tell you.
Someone said Will Smith is the king of Philly. Yes, he is.
In terms of money and fame, yeah.
Yeah, he's and Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart's also a king too.
Philly
got multiple kings.
A true king.
Ooh, we'll get to the WAC 100. We're gonna get there. Trust me. So,
like I said to them before, I don't know if they heard me. A true king is a person who take care of his people, take care of his community, take care of his family. You understand what I'm saying?
That's true.
What a true king
Someone
is.
That's responsible and handles the business.
See, y'all gonna get school here. Y'all come here, Daily Hip Hop Live. We gonna drop some gems, talk about hip hop, and we dealing with moral codes and integrity.
Okay, so
no racism too. That's another thing. Y'all can kill the racism too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, wreck. Okay, so we're gonna get to this WAC 100. Okay. Okay. And then we're going to get back to the Beanie Siegel interview because there's still more to cover, okay?
Where you want to go with the WAC?
Okay, the WAC 100.
Aspect, or you want to go from WAC speaking on Meek and Tifa?
Okay, now there's a lot to go with the WAC 100 aspect, okay? Right. First, there was the Beanie Siegel portion, okay? Where Beanie Siegel got beat up. He said that needs to be rectified and fixed because that was a violation. They said Beanie Siegel didn't tell them anything regarding, like, you know, strategy and everything, okay? Beanie Siegel talked about this on the podcast. He said, I just called game and kind of because Meek Mill was kind of showing signs that he wasn't really in this. This ain't real. Because Beanie Siegel was asking Meek, yo, what's up? What's going? And then Meek was like, chill. And Beanie Siegel was like, oh, so you're not really about the beef. I'm about it. So he called game like, yo, he kind of squashed it because he ain't going to go jump off the ladder, you know, jump off the edge of the building for somebody who ain't in the beef 100%. And Meek just reacted too late because he called Beans after that. He already made the call to game and squashed everything. And game said some real shit to him. He said, yo, you said you're going to get on a flight and come to Cali. That means Beanie Siegel's going to get on a flight and come to Cali. And we're going to have a real live problem here. Right?
Thanks.
So he had to, he said, I had to come at you like that, because what would you have done? You would have done the same thing. I took notes from you with the Beanie Siegel, Jadakiss, D-Block beef.
And Beanie said he respected
what he had, Beanie said to him. He had to respect it. And then he also said, yo, what did he say about the whole thing with the Jadakiss shit?
He said, what else he said?
He said something to Game, how he respected something else about him. Game came at him a certain way. Basically called him OG.
I don't remember it entirely, but it was pretty much along the aspect you spoke about.
Yeah, it was a respect thing.
That was the gist of it. That was the gist of it.
That was the gist of it. So then Meek tried to call Beans and said, yo, let's go win, right?
Yeah, after he saw the Breakfast Club interview.
Right. After he saw that Breakfast Club interview.
Then Beans is like, hold on, let me look at the Breakfast Club interview. And that's when Beans...
That's what it was. That's what I meant to say.
Yeah.
Beans didn't hear the 92 Bars track, so he didn't know that Game was giving it up to Beans and making it clear that it's just a beef between him and Meek because of something Meek... Now, this is where we're going to get back to WAC 100. That something Meek did that was lame, okay? WAC 100 is like, yo, all you guys doing this beating up Beans, this all goes back to Meek, and the original lame shit he did was gossip with Sean Kingston saying that he got robbed by Game, putting that out in the air, when that was false, right? So he was gossiping and running his mouth, according to WAC 100, and then basically saying, yo, this all originated with Meek, not Beans. Beans had nothing to do with it. Beans was just being a real dude, okay? And this would have never got this far if Meek didn't start ratting and telling Sean Kingston that Game... robbed Sean Kingston and put that in the air.
Facts.
So Game had a real reason to beef with Meek. It wasn't just made up. And when Beans understood that, I'm sure that was relayed and he didn't say that in the tax
stone. I just think the timing with Game, it makes it kind of suspect.
He definitely waited for his album to come out. Let's be honest about that too. Yeah. Game definitely waited for his album to come out to get into this beef. To make it make sense for him, do his rounds with media, and really capitalize off of the media presence and capitalize off of album sales, okay? Now, I think that's playing chess, guys. That's really playing chess. Making it make sense for your life at the same time. I mean, come on. That's playing chess, too, because you know you're making your media rounds. And you can talk about Meek Mill on all the media outlets and really, really get your message out there.
Yes, so, sir.
Who's playing chess here? Game's playing chess. Game was ready with disc number 2 within 24 hours. Where's Meek's disc? Where is Meek's disc?
I don't know, fam.
I want to hear it, though. You want to hear it?
Hell yeah, I want to hear it.
Okay, so WAC 100 is basically saying this has to do with your man Meek. This has to be rectified. Somebody got to make right on this. He's basically calling people to go beat up the guy who beat up Beanie Siegel because he jumped out the window. Right?
Yes, sir.
And WAC 100 at a point, bro. I'm going to be right. And then he also made one last really good point. The same thing Meek Mill called Drake out on. Oh, you didn't write your verses on my album. That was supposedly his real problem with Drake. You didn't shout out my album and you didn't write your verses, right? But then we're having a problem. Beanie Siegel coming forward accusing you of the same thing and you're going to beat him up for the same exact thing? Come on. You're being a hypocrite. That's what you call being a hypocrite. It's okay when you do it, but when somebody else does it, it's a big problem.
Right now, are we talking music or are we talking about Meek Mill's man credibility?
Which Meek Mill's man's credibility? Which one?
As a man, because...
Oh, no, we're just talking about, I mean, you know what? Like, part of you being a rapper and a person, it all comes together. It all comes together. You know? They're gonna... You're the real person you are is gonna come out in your raps if you're really a genuine rapper, right? And you're really rapping about your life, it's going to come forth, right? So, like, and you're supposed, especially in street rap, you're supposed to be authentic, right? You got to be authentic, right? So you got to be who you are. So this is who Meek is. That's all I, that's what you're showing me who you are. Any rapper, I gotta take you for what you're giving me.
Facts. Well, speaking on that.
Right, what's up?
I gotta promote this event. I'll be there tonight. If y'all in Brooklyn, come out. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna touch that stage. Shouts to my man Jay Ronan. It's his birthday party. It's at Lucky 13 Saloon in Brooklyn. You know what I mean?
Okay, so go check out Street. Go check out Rec.
The MREC and China Black, we touching that stage.
Okay.
In probably like an hour or so. So I'm here live streaming with y'all, and I ain't even prepped for the show or nothing. But, you know, I love this whole live stream show, Daily Hip Hop Live, me and my man Jordan.
Yeah.
And, you know, I make the sacrifice.
Okay, let's get right back into it, though. Let's get right back into it, right?
Hey, fuck what I'm doing. Let's,
I mean, that was good, but let's keep it moving. Get right back into it, right? What do you feel about the Beanie Siegel interview? I thought it was the best interview of 2016. I got to shout out Taxstone right now.
Yeah,
you got a great interview, and Taxstone did it. I mean, you know, like this. Mwah, I got to do it like a pizza. Mwah, because you didn't talk too much. You let Beanie Siegel do the talking, and we got it out.
Taxstone let Beanie Siegel speak, and that's the thing that a lot.
That's what you do. This with an interview like that, just like you make a great pizza. You go, mwah, that was a great interview. It was a great.
See, what a lot of people don't understand, you gotta let people speak, especially in a podcast or you conducting an interview.
Yeah.
You gotta let the artist speak, because they're gonna.
Yeah, you gotta test the temperature of the interview, and he read it perfectly.
So, salute to Taxstone, salute to Beanie Siegel. That's a classic interview. Me,
yeah.
I just tip my hat off and I salute. Like, I'm not a dick rider, I'm not a hater, but when something's hot, I just salute, man.
I mean, DJ Self had to back down out of that, and that was really supposed to be his interview. He had to back because Beans had something to say, he had something to say. Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, he covered everything.
That was important. That was important. That was a.
Okay, so Rec, you're Meek Mill right now. Put yourself in Meek Mill's shoes, okay? What are you going to do right now? How are you going to react and come back from this, okay? Game's killing you. Mm-hmm. Not only did he diss you twice, you only came back once, but on top of that, he released a music video going to different hoods in different states. I mean, he's showing that the people are fucking with him.
I'm going to be honest with you. Meek Mill... whole campaign right now need to be about retaliation.
Right.
Towards Game. And definitely he has to, you know, respond to Beanie Siegel.
Right.
Because in both aspects, his career ended. You understand?
Yeah. No, I understand.
Beanie Siegel destroyed Meek credibility.
Yeah.
Game went after both. Lyrical capability as well as capability, period. Street credibility, whatever.
Yeah.
So, Meek right now has a lot of weight on his shoulders.
Too much, man.
So, he has to get busy in that booth.
Mm-hmm.
And definitely needs to sit down with somebody outside of the commercial platforms. You need to sit down with somebody that's going to let Meek show the real side of him. Like, that nobody has seen yet. Because that was a Beanie Siegel. Because Siegel always give you, you know, his heart and soul. But that right there was everything. Siegel spilled it all.
Yeah.
If you didn't know Beanie Siegel by now, that interview right there, definitely.
Beanie Siegel is always going to be. Now, he's above the king of Philly. He's the OG of Philly. He had Philly, like, who said this? He carried Philly on his back for 20 years.
Facts.
20 years, okay? He always repped Philly, and he said, I ain't repping North Philly, I ain't repping South Philly, I ain't repping West Philly, East Philly, I'm repping Philly.
That's what he said.
He's repping Philly. He's not repping a certain part of Philly. He's repping the whole thing. Guys, I'm going to read off on, so let's get you guys involved, and then we're going to tackle this WAC 100 in Mano beef. Okay? Because this is going on now, too. There's so many side beefs.
Oh, man.
So many side pieces of beef. It's like, it's almost like you're at Fogo de Chow's, and you're like, I want the garlic beef, or I want the filet mignon, or right? A lot of those little side beefs going on here, right?
I mean, in rap right now, not only lyrical capabilities are being tested, but people hand skills are being tested. Because Wack pretty much told Maino,
yeah,
make sure you lace up them boots. Because I don't want to hear no excuses. Because come catch this fade. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And Maino responded on some, listen, however you want to do this fade, I give you a Caesar, a Baldy.
Come on, man.
Back top.
Come on.
A Gumby, Maino.
You know what's really weird to me, though? We're from New York, right, Rack? We're from New York. Hey. Are we going to go out to Cali and start talking crazy like that?
Nah.
Like, that's kind of, like,
what? I got a set of balls.
I don't know what to think here about this. I don't know how to feel about it because he's in New York talking crazy to New York rappers. It feels weird, bro. I'm going to be honest with you. Like, back in the day, never, nobody would ever try that back.
Time has changed, bro. Listen, time is going to tell for everything, right? I want to see or hear about, because I'm pretty sure they're not going to publicize the fight if they do fight, Maino and Wack.
Nobody's fighting anybody here. We both know everybody is making false threats. Nobody's fighting anybody. The only real thing I'm concerned about is that Philly beef between Beanie Siegel and Meek Mill right now, because they, not between those two particular guys, the guys around them. They're going to react. They're going to be bumping to each other at the cheesesteak place now on Broad Street. There goes son. Let's catch him. And casualties happen because of this, unfortunately.
No, you know what's crazy?
What's up?
It might get crazy tonight.
Yeah, and you know what? I hope it doesn't wreck. I'm going to be honest with you.
Me too.
I hope Beanie Siegel makes that call to his people.
Listen, Beanie Siegel's, the words he spoke, those was the truth.
Yo, I'm going to tell you something, Rec.
It had a lot of truth in it. Not to say you're right. Everything he said was the truth, but you could tell he was speaking from the bottom of his stomach.
Right.
Speaking from the heart.
I'm going to tell you something, man. We need A.R.A.B., like what he said before. A.R.A.B. said all the bosses need to come together and sit down. That needs to happen right now. Like, right now.
It went too far.
It went too far right now. This Beanie Siegel interview got way Beanie too Siegel personal.
Got touch.
Yeah, okay, that's where it went wrong. First of all, Meek Mill, not only, I don't think we addressed this. We did a little bit, but like, okay, so Meek Mill was mad at Beanie Siegel for basically telling him, yo, you ain't got that stamp yet, man. You ain't the dude yet. Make sure you come back at game. He was giving him advice for the game beef and beefs and everything. And like, yo, you going this way. And Meek Mill, being emotional, said, yo, I got more money than you. You ain't shit. You da-da-da-da-da. And then he threatened Beanie Siegel. And then Beanie Siegel got touched. So it was a real threat. And then Beanie Siegel was looking back like, oh, word? You're going to threaten me? But he didn't take it seriously, because it's Meek Mill, and he knows Meek Mill in his mind isn't street like him, so he's like, it's an empty threat. Well, Meek Mill did get Beanie Siegel touched, and Beanie Siegel was like, yo, you got a young bull coming at me over 300 pounds, and he's chasing the carrot, not knowing he's never going to catch that carrot. You're promising, Meek Mill's promising these guys things that he can't deliver on, and this is Meek Mill. I'm going to be honest with you, Rec. We've seen this story many times. You'd be promising these street dudes shit. And if you don't follow through, you become the food. You don't want to play with them streets like that. You don't want to make false promises, man. This is another thing. When you have a big entourage and they do things for you and they end up in jail, that costs you money for the rest of your life. Because now you got to take care of his family. And you got to take care of him while he's in jail. I mean, you don't want these costs, right? Unless you need it. Like a Jeezy or somebody, he kind of need it because he really lived that street life, you know?
Thanks.
So he's at three. He's in danger anytime he goes out to a club. You don't know when your pass is going to catch up to you. And yeah, you're like, oh, the white guy's telling me this. Trust me, I've been around enough street stuff in the past 15 years of stuff I should have never experienced when growing up in the way I grew up. You know that, Rec. You've seen me in different... I'm out of pocket most of the time in these environments, but I'm doing my passion of music videos and music, and, you know, I've experienced a lot, and I understand this stuff, you know? So, it is what it is, you know?
I get it. Yeah. I get it, man. I mean, you know, How do you feel about the snippet? It's a few snippets Meek released. I didn't hear the
They're looking one. Good. I like the one with Quavo the best. Okay, you got the Migos, Migos track, and I think he actually has a video to that already shot that's not out yet. I'm looking forward to DC4. Meek Mill does deliver good music when he delivers it. Even when he delivered that four album snippet before he went back on house arrest, that shit was hot, man. And he had a bunch of videos for it, and it had a good feeling. I want to hear DC4, but when Meek goes through these beefs and he's not holding his own, it makes you not want to like check the interview so much, you know? I mean, what doesn't make you want to check the mixtape so much, you know?
Yeah.
It throws you off.
It was another joint that he put out. I was digging that. I don't know the name of it, but he just showed the track board. I was kind of digging that.
Yeah. He had the thing pointed out at the track board and played. Yeah, that shit was fire, man.
Yeah.
That was fire.
I was digging that.
Let's read a little comments from the thing. Now, I want to get back into another thing in a second. Meek is still on probation. Meek, that's true.
Yeah,
oh my gosh, man. Yo, all these things, you're getting Beanie Siegel. You're opening a can of worms when you're still on probation, bro. You're going to go, like, you're asking for trouble. Exactly. I guarantee you, Meek Mill, I mean, and I don't wish this upon anybody. You know his PO off. You've dealt with POs before, like people that have PO officers, right? Before, right? Right?
Yeah, definitely. I dealt with one today. I had to go see my PO today.
Yeah, so you know, they might call him in right now, right?
If it get real valid and his name is involved and they got credible information, yeah.
Yeah, King Dominic, what's up? Enrique Perez, Young MC, Ben Allen, Samaya Kane. She always comes in, man. Or him. That's him. I'm sorry, man.
Salute, man.
I don't know who I don't know. Samaya is a rap name or whatever. You got to clarify that for me because I can only see a little picture of you, so I don't know what it is. You know what you mean, but he gonna drag Nicki down with him. I think.
Oh,
I don't think that's gonna
game right there. Who said that?
Low key, I think. No. Somebody else said that. Why Jordan so extra? Stay in your lane. Be neutral. I'm Rec Cool Comma Collective. BK style. I'm not from Brooklyn, that's why. I'm from the Bronx. awesome MREC TV, much respect. Shout out to Steady B Cool C. Here, little pup. No one wants a RICO case. No, nobody wants a RICO case. Avery, what's good? Samaya, I didn't see what you wrote. Youngzilla, Julio. Sorry. Designers are Russ. Sorry, these chats going real fast, guys. Low key 100.
Are they typing up, huh? That's what's up, man.
Young Ink. Tell me. Yo, if you want a shout out, just type your name out and I'll read it like that. It's better. Type the name out you want to shout out. And Sediment. Syracuse, New York. What's good? This is more about the hypocrite Meek Millie. He is he's looking like a hypocrite now. I want to hear Meek Mill's side of the story because there are always three sides of the story. There's three sides of the story. Beanie's side, Meek's side. And then the truth.
And the truth, of course.
Yes.
Four sides. Because, you know, you got...
Well, that's totally different. We're talking about this Philly beef right now, right, Rack?
Oh, well, yeah.
That's what we're really concerned about now. This.
It was sparked.
Yeah, but it kind of changed. It kind of changed today.
No, it was sparked.
It was true. It's true, but it kind of changed today. Let's be honest.
All right, but let's change the course a little bit, right?
Okay, cool.
What do you think Drake is thinking right now?
Drake is sitting back like, yes.
Mm.
Somebody else finished him off for me.
You think Drake got his feet kicked up, eating his popcorn?
Drake's probably about to perform tonight. He's going to celebrate, probably take a couple groupies back to the room. Mm. And he's going to celebrate like a true boss. Because Beanie Siegel even said it. He lost that beef. And we all know Meek Mill lost that beef. Because he took too long to respond. That's what I always say. Not because of the bars. Because he took too long to respond. And he's doing it again with the game thing. And that's what Beanie Siegel said. He said, again with the game thing, he's not responding on time. And it makes you lose, man. And that is the key. You got to... Game knows how to beef. He came back 24 hours. Didn't give you a chance to breathe.
Timing is everything.
Yes. So Meek Mill... Oh, someone said DC Forge. People keep telling me DC Forge dropping Friday. Where are you seeing this?
Nah, I heard that too.
No, we've been hearing this through the chat. But, hey, I've been hearing DC Forge snippets for a year now. I'm going to be honest with you. I've been hearing DC Forge snippets for a year.
Don't forget to support that Patreon.
Don't forget to support the Patreon, guys. If you really mess with our podcast, this is like a YouTube podcast, okay? It's different than we don't do things right.
I like to spend a few,
But just make sure you click that link below and support us. Okay, go ahead, Rick.
I like to spend a few of our daily viewers, say. Like a better TMZ. What they say, how they refer to us?
We're the Hood TMZ.
The Hood TMZ? Yeah, I like
that. Yeah.
TMZ get a lot of money. So
yeah.
We'll take that.
Secure the bag alert.
You said secure the bag alert?
Yeah.
Secure the bag alert.
Yeah, because guys, like, if you have products or you want to, guys, see this window right here? This could be you talking with us some days. Like right here, we have a Patreon level for that where you can donate a certain amount per month. Help us make this better because we want to get like, guys, if you guys start donating to this, I'll be paying for bigger artists to come on here. Sometimes they need some motivation.
No, we're going to get some artists, but we're going to get some strippers and all that. Y'all want some girls twerking?
We ain't getting no girls twerking in here. Let's just be honest. We don't lie in here.
Let's just see what they want.
Girls don't lie. Yeah, but YouTube doesn't like that, unfortunately.
Yeah, but
how much to get on that screen? Callie, you go to the Patreon link below this video, and there's a money amount for that, and then I honor everything. Guys, okay, we're losing people in here because we're talking too much about Patreon. We got to get back to this beef, Rec.
Let's get to it.
Okay. So I'm thinking, okay, what's going on, guys? You see Mano and Wack 100 going at it, and then he's explaining himself like, yo, Game was able to come to New York and shoot all these videos, and I see my homies in there, and they looking lame, and I'm calling them out, calling them lame on the phone. So I'm talking to them straight up. I'm calling them lame, right? So Mano... But who was in the video that's supposed to be down with Mano? Uncle Murder. So is Mano calling out Uncle Murder for being in the Game video in New York City? That's the question here. And nobody's addressing this. I've seen it on a few forums. Rex put me up on it. I thought these guys were cool because I moved out of New York City a few years ago and I can't test the climate. Like Rex is live in Brooklyn right now.
Live in East New York.
He's in East New York. He knows what's going on in Brooklyn. He saw Game with his own two eyes shooting in pink houses. He drove by. He peeped. He saw it with his own two eyes. He saw Uncle Murder there before it even went up on Snapchat.
Listen, I get the calls about pretty much 90% of everything that's going on
in New York. If something's moving in New York, if a Subway sandwich is getting eaten in New York, if someone goes into a bodega and they buy a Pepsi... Rec knows about it. He gets that phone call.
Facts. They patch in with me. Trust me.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
If a dime gets sold on the corner, Rec wants in.
I want in, baby.
He's getting notified. Now, Rec's heavily connected in Brooklyn. So basically, Game, Mano's saying he feels disrespected that Game is going around New York and shooting a music video, and all his boys are in it, jumping in the middle of a beef they have nothing to do with, right? Come on, man. Come on.
How you feel about that?
I feel like he's trying to be a part of the beef, and Mano, feel free to correct me if you see this, but I'm just looking at it from the outside in. I haven't spoken to Mano in 5 years, you know, so I don't know what Mano's thinking right now. We don't have a phone relationship, so I can't tell you.
I'm going to be honest with you. I spoke to Mano maybe like 2 months ago.
Less. What do you think is going on? Because we did see Mano post up a picture saying nobody's here, kind of taking a slight shot. Wack 100 called him out for it. And basically, I mean, we're here now. They Wack 100 and Mano going back at it. And Mano had subliminals in his text his Instagrams to Wack 100 coming at Uncle Murder. I thought these guys were cool, man. They had a tape together, didn't they? They did videos together. I know they had a problem in the past, but I thought they put all that aside and said we're on this King of Brooklyn shit.
Well, let me tell you something. Like, okay. In Brooklyn, Brooklyn is so repetitious. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, like, everybody from Brooklyn want to rep the hardest. Everybody wants to be a king. Everybody wants to be the best.
Right.
You understand?
Right.
You know, just the whole New York, the king of New York.
Yeah, New York is competitive. There's a reason why they came out with a movie called King of New York.
But Brooklyn is different, though.
Yeah.
It's a different type of competitiveness in Brooklyn.
Okay.
It's like, nobody else is going to stand next to a dude on some, like, yo, he's the king of Brooklyn?
Yeah.
Well, I'm the god of Brooklyn. That's how dudes feel. Like, you understand what I'm saying?
Do you think Maino was calling out Uncle Murder in that post?
I mean, do I think?
Yeah.
I'm put it to you like this.
Do you think or do you know? I mean, let me know.
This is what the people were saying in the post. The people were saying that.
Underneath the post, they were commenting.
Yes, they were saying that.
And unlike Meek Mill, Maino doesn't turn his comments off.
I guess not.
That's another thing Beanie Siegel addressed. He said, you turning your comments off on your Instagram? I didn't even know you could do that. It must really be getting to him, all these comments talking about he can't handle all the mouses underneath his comments. It's eating him alive. And he said, you let your lady run you. He said, you let your lady run you. When you come home, you're the boss. You set the tone. And especially when your lady doesn't need money.
You on fire today, Jordan.
I mean, I'm just spitting the interview that Beanie Siegel said. This isn't coming from my... But I'm not coming up with this. I'm not making this up. This is the truth, guys. This is what was said.
This is Jordan Tower in weird form right now.
Hey, let's share this post and let's get more people in here because it just gets me fired up and I just start speaking my mind. Okay? Share the post. Tweet it out. Share it on your Facebook. So let's get people in here. We're going to start going into the chat. We're going to start reading out what you guys got to say. We're going to address situations. He said Maino was checking Uncle Murder. That's what Samaya said. Samaya Kane checking Uncle Murder on the low subliminally.
Samaya Kane for her thoughts.
I mean, that's the truth. Maino, a hating broke New York record. Maino is not broke, okay? I'll clear that up right now.
Yo, I'm going to be honest with you.
What's up?
I like when y'all say crazy shit because that shit make me laugh. You know what I'm saying? That's entertaining. Yeah.
Shout out to Charlie. He said, Jordan Tower's on fire. I'm on fire. Get me more on fire and share this post. We want more people in this room.
Shit, I'm going to just sit back in the passenger seat and just coast. My man on fire. I ain't a hater. I'm saluting, baby. Yeah.
What's that character on the final? The four? Has the fire come out of his hands? That's me right now. Woo! Flame. What is his name? Flamer? Flame guy. Maino ain't paying nobody. That's what another thing of Beanie said. He said, yo, when I was on, everybody looked rich. Everybody was driving my whips when I was out of town. Let my homies hold the Bentley and the Ferrari. Meek Mill's people look dirty. That's what he said. What do you think? I think his homies look kind of flashy. O'Malley's got jewelry.
Uh-huh.
I mean, come on. I don't see who's broken Dream Chasers. I'm not seeing
it. Well, you know, the sayings go, you ain't rich till you make other people around you rich.
Okay, I see what you're saying. But Beanie Siegel, who did he make rich? Well, he made Freeway rich, right?
I can't say who he made rich because you know why?
What's up?
These are my guys, PD Crack, O'Skino, because if I call them, it's going to be a whole different conversation.
Okay, but like, okay, O'Skino, Petey Crack, all them, right? Right? They made millions? At one point? You know them.
Look, I can't say they made millions. Petey Crack had like $1 million budget. His budget was $900,000, and he said he ran through that. That's a fact.
His budget was $900,000, but like, was that in his bank account, or was that his budget for the whole album?
Budget for the whole album.
And they gave it to him, or they... He spent it on features and everything.
Well, he was, I guess, in control of it because he said he fucked that shit up.
So that was, basically what Petey Crack didn't understand, I think, is that was his advance and he blew through it because your budget and your advance is totally different.
No, I think it was everything because he was able to get, you know, the producers he wanted.
Oh, so he basically probably worked it out with them like, yo, give me that. I'll have my own studio. Like, just how Joel Santana and Cameron freaked their budgets. Like, they built their own studio so they could take the studio budget.
But the only thing, I don't think Petey Crack built his own studio. You know what I'm saying?
Well, obviously he didn't. I mean, he'd be in a different place today.
Yeah, so.
But Petey Crack is nice. Philly got spins.
Matter of fact, Petey Crack destroyed that BET cipher, too.
Which one?
I think it came out yesterday or it's coming out today.
Really?
Yeah.
What made them put Petey Crack in that cipher?
I think they had state property in it. You know what I'm saying? I don't know the whole set. But I caught a wind. I didn't catch the whole cipher, but.
Someone said, Samaya's saying some shit today. Said Beanie Siegel didn't want to talk about state property with tax.
Woo.
That's true. I'm sure there's. Okay, now. Tiffy touched on this. He said Beanie Siegel been doing a lot of fuck shit too. Let's tell both sides of the story. Right? Mm-hmm. He said Beanie Siegel been supposed to get beat up. But when you backstab the Chasers, you got beat up. So the same way Beanie Siegel's coming out and doing Tax Stone and spilling the beans on everything. Spilling the beans. Okay. We're going to hear from Tiffy in about... We'll probably hear about Tiffy from Tiffy on Hip Hop Since 1987 in a day or two. Maybe tomorrow. Maybe tonight. They're probably over there filming right now because he was alluding to that Beans doesn't keep it 100 either. So we got to see what's going on. But I wouldn't poke Beans too much because Beans is like you said, he's a legend in Philly. People he doesn't even know will do something for Beans. He got that kind of love.
Thanks.
You don't want to mess with that. Meek Mill's still kind of fresh. You know, he's two albums in, but he hasn't solidified himself as a legend yet. He's not a legend yet. I'm going to be honest with you. A.R. Ab, and Philly-wise, is more of a legend than Meek Mill right now. Because A.R. Ab's in Philly every day, and he got that love in Philly.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling the truth, right, Rec?
Are you dropping gems?
We're talking Philly-wise, not worldwide. We know Meek Mill's the bigger artist worldwide, but in Philly, A.R. Ab gets love. They love him in Philly.
To be legendary in your town, you have to win the town love.
Yeah, and you know, I'm going to tell you one thing.
It has to be genuine.
Yeah,
but you understand what I'm saying?
A guy like A.R. Ab looks up to Beanie Siegel, man.
Yes.
All OBH does. So that's a dangerous game Meek Mill's playing right now because he's not in California right now. Living in Beverly Hills.
All right, let's do this, y'all. I want to know what the...
I'm scared for Meek right now. I'm gonna be honest, and his people. I don't want to see anybody get hurt. You know, let's be honest.
Yeah, I don't want to see nobody get hurt, but at the same time,
like this is getting a little too crazy now. I like the Meek and Game thing. We knew nothing was really gonna happen, right? We knew that.
All right, but this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna turn up the room.
Okay.
Place your bets: Beanie Siegel versus Meek Mill. Who you got? I want to see people type this. Who you got? I need to know. Who's going to win this unanimously?
Let's see.
What are you saying right now?
Someone said O'Malley been whacked, somebody said. Somebody said that.
What are you talking about, O'Malley?
O'Malley, another Meek. Meek is a Meek is going to retire and convert to Islam.
Woo!
Young Ink, you scared?
Who said that?
That guy. Beanie. Someone said Beanie. John Wick said Beanie. Samaya Kane, Beanie. Okay. Albion Graham, Beanie, Young Ink, Woo. Beans will kill Meek, King Turk, Beans hands down, Los, Beans hands down, Moses 187, Beans hands down, Luke wow. Keys, Bay, the Bay family wins. I guess that's Tiffy Bay. Tommy Lee Taylor, how you look like, Break Harp, you don't have to be gangster, Meek should have just kept it 100. Low-key 100. Meek's last two albums was Trizash. Beanie got history on the streets. Samaya Kane. Kelly Bucks. Beanie will win. Close the books. Connie B. Mac. Chris 714. 40s Crips.
Hold on. It was a landslide?
Let's put it this way, guys. Are we talking rap battle or in the street stardom instead?
We could talk rap battle. We could talk about street credibility.
Rap. Let's talk rap battle. Youngzilla. Hi, Jordan. What's up, man? King Tyrek, don't fuck my name up. King Tyrek, I'm trying, bro. I'm trying with the names. Young Ink, Beans the truth.
Beans won by a landslide in Daily Hip Hop.
Beans won. Now, guys, I'm going to just put this out there, and we're going to get right back into it. No, but let's get into this, okay? See this window right here? If you go to the Patreon link below and you donate the amount you need, you will be featured on here, and you'll banter with us every, like, a couple times a month. That'll be dope. Or if you're an artist and you want to spit live on the show in the middle of us talking the news, you just break into a verse, or you want to debut your next video, just go to that Patreon and support this podcast so we can get better people in here. Come on, we got Mr. Fab coming in here. We're going to have Petey Crack. We reached out to Cassidy, Riff Raff. We reached out to 3-6 Mafia, Turk. Who else? Rocco. And OJ the Juice Man, all these people are coming in here to do interviews, but not only an interview, they're going to be talking about the news, like what they think about the game beef and all that. Do you guys like Zoe Dallas? He's going to be up here in a day or two. I just spoke to him. Okay? This is going to be hot. You think it's cool when, Drink Champs and all them post once a week? How about once a day? They can't keep up with us. Okay? This is the new Breakfast Club.
Yo, my man JT is on fire. Rare form.
This is gonna be the new YouTube Breakfast Club. Oh, not with shit. The radio. This is YouTube Breakfast Club right here. Shit. This is gonna be us. Okay, shit. Guys? Young Zoe Dallas, what do you want Zoe Dallas to talk about? Let's tweet go. Me at
you
Jordan Tower.
So much,
what's up?
So much, the polo horse on your shirt.
It's like turning into a Ferrari horse. Where is it? Horses.
Your polo horse is flaming.
How I subscribe. Head honcho. Go to the Patreon below. Click the link.
Go to that Patreon.
And yes, RIP Shorty Low. Beyonce did a tribute to Shorty Low. Gave me chills. Chills. She did a dance to Day No.
All praise due to Beyonce, RIP Shorty Low. Yo, respect to the Queen Beyonce.
Yo, Beyonce, salute. I mean, shout out to everybody that, like, T.I. even gave it up. He said he truly repped Bankhead and Bowen Holmes. And he gave it up. He was a true legend. I mean, he gave it up, man. Shout out to Rocco for giving up for Shorty Low. Rocco and Shorty Low were real friends from the streets before rap.
Yep.
And I'm going to get Rocco's opinion on that in a day or two. Okay, he's going to be right up here talking about that. Maybe tomorrow. I might surprise you.
You better stay locked.
Someone said Breakfast Club sucks. I like the Breakfast Club. They get good interviews, but I'm just comparing that because everybody refers to the Breakfast Club. And, you know.
Yo, those are all my homies. Charlamagne.
Yeah, they got a good show.
DJ Envy. I go way back.
This is raw and uncut Breakfast Club. I mean, call it ghetto, whatever you want. It's just a YouTube show. We just go live and we go off the. We ain't planning this out.
And we talking to the people.
Yeah, I didn't write a script for this.
Yeah.
We're talking about Meek Mill, Beanie Siegel, game beef. Uh-huh. Mano versus Uncle Murder. There's so many side beefs going on.
We talking to the people, though, too. We shouting y'all.
You can't interact with the Breakfast Club live. I'm reading your comments right now. Nori be doing that irritating Funkmaster Flex, cutting people off. You know, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to cut people off, too. If they stumbling, I'm going to finish their sentence for them. But they don't do that. But I keep the interview moving. Even with my boy Rec up here, we call each other out. We got that kind of relationship. He'll tell me when I'm fucking up, and I'll tell him when he's fucking up. That's what a real friend does. No yes men. We want no men. Love how you guys be speaking things into existence. Oh, well, that's going to happen. And you know what? We're reporting live. I don't care if we get 5,000 views, 20,000 views, 100,000 views. I do this for fun.
Yeah.
I love it. I love this culture.
Doing rehearsal for, and I'm still here with y'all and my man JT.
Yeah.
Giving y'all the facts on what's going on in hip-hop currently.
Yeah. Well, anyways, guys, I'm going to tell you one thing, okay? And I got to reiterate this, and I'm sorry to beat a dead horse, okay? But there's this link below called Patreon, and that's how you support this broadcast. We don't make no money off of this. Nothing, okay? We want to reinvest in it, though. I'm not trying to put this money in my pockets, okay? I'm going to reinvest in the podcast, this podcast, live, YouTube, live, whatever it is, okay? It's amazing. The show is amazing, and we're going to make it more amazing. I want to have the best rappers on here. And, you know, sometimes you got to throw them something, or I got to give them something. I got to figure it out, okay? So we need money to work with to get better equipment.
We might need to buy them champagne or a Henny bottle or something.
Yeah, sometimes you got to give these guys things to be on the podcast. Do I sound thirsty? Trey says I sound thirsty. No. We do this for free, so we need support sometimes. If you don't want to give, you can enjoy it for free, bro. I mean, I'm just saying, if you want to support us, and Trey, I'm also trying to include you in it even more. I'm going to put a fan in this box by next week. Somebody's going to give that donation, and they're going to be in this, and we're going to be bantering with them, and they're going to give their opinion. Okay, you want to get a shout out on here? Do you have a product, or do you have t-shirts you want to go? You want a promo on here? It's not even that expensive. It's like $100 a month, and we'll wear your stuff. We'll plug your website, all that kind of stuff during the broadcast because we appreciate the support, okay? Yeah. And I just want to put that out there. If you're a new artist coming up and, you know, you want to be on here and you want to tell people who you are in the middle of a news broadcast, so we just slip it in there, that's a good idea, and you should donate for that. And then you can also be part of the banter about the hip-hop conversation. I would love to have one of you guys up here talking about your opinions on Game. And we could, you know, maybe you'll give us a different perspective. But also, we'll have the guys in the chat room over here talking. And we're always reading the chat. I'm taking things from the chat. Sorry, I can't always shout you out. Because your names be kind of crazy sometimes. Okay. Jordan Radio, all tune in, bro. Thanks a lot. And I appreciate you guys' support if you go to Patreon. Okay, so what else do you guys want to talk about? Have we covered everything in this? I mean, we've pretty much covered everything. We got Mano and Uncle Murder Beef, and hopefully they work everything out. We got WAC 100 and Mano. I think they already deaded that on the phone, okay? Because they don't want anything real crazy happening. The real thing we got to be worried about right now is Beanie Siegel and Meek Mill, because that could turn real ugly for other people them. So let's hope they're all sitting down. Maybe ARAB is organizing some little sit down right now and they can figure this out. I don't want anybody to die behind some hip hop beef. Come on. You don't get into hip hop to die behind hip hop, okay? This isn't moving keys and moving weed and, you know, fucking getting a connect. It's not like that. This is straight art, okay? Do you think painters die over painting? I mean, come on. Yeah, but, you know, the rap does reflect the environment you're talking about. So, you know, that element is going to be brought into it. You know, Ice-T said it best. You're rapping about the streets. The street element is going to be around you and in your music. You know, it's going to reflect. It's not authentic if you don't reflect what you're spitting. Okay?
Thanks.
Now, I want you guys to get off this broadcast. Come back tomorrow. I want you to have a great day tomorrow. And remember when you wake up that you're special, and you are going to accomplish everything you want. Everything will be okay. Do everything to your best potential, okay? And go in there, and don't be scared to ask for that raise or quit your job and pursue your passion. Just know everything will be okay, okay? Put things out in the universe that you want to accomplish. We're not the next Breakfast Club yet, but we will be the next Breakfast Club on YouTube, okay? So just remember that. You will get everything you want. Anything else you want to add, Rick?
Yo, just keep tuning in to Daily Hip Hop Live. And
yes.
Appreciate all the love. Follow me on Instagram at MRECGM, MRECKGM.
Yep.
And subscribe to MREC TV.
At Jordan Tower JTF. Go to that, hit that Patreon and support. We love you guys for tuning in, and we're nothing without you guys. I'm going to end the stream and get in the chat and talk to you guys for a little bit, and then we're going to end the night. You guys, you be safe tonight. Wear your seatbelts. I wish Shorty Low was wearing a seatbelt. Rest in peace to my good friend Shorty Low. I miss you, bro. I miss you, man.